Hello everyone. So today we are demonstrating the apparatus which is called profile projector. The basic use of profile projector is when we have to measure the minor details or all the details of any screw thread or gear, or we have to measure the tool angle for single point cutting tool, then we use this profile projector. The basic function of profile projector is that it, with the help of lenses and lights, it magnify the projections. Like if you talk about this bolt, then the profile of these screw thread we can't measure with our naked eyes, or we can't use the vernier caliper for some of the dimensions, like we have to measure the pitch angle or minor diameter. So then we magnify this profile or this profile projector, and then we measure on this profile projector. For measuring this, we have to take the reading. So in profile projector there are two beds. One bed is movable in x direction and other bed is movable on y direction. So for movement of x and y direction, to measure this, here is a micrometer. The working of micrometer is same as we use like screw gauge. If you can see, then here are readings like a micrometer. There are two scale. One is main scale and other one is circular scale. For the least count of this profile projector is for one unit in main scale, it rotates about 100 parts on circular scale. So least count is 1 divided by 100. So 0.01 is the least count of both the micrometer scales. For angle measurement, there is this on the screen, there is an angle written on from 0 to 360 degree, and this angular scale is also divided in vernier scale. So here is on vernier scale, there is 30 parts. So least count for angle measurement is 1 degree, for vernier scale is 30 part, then 1 divided by 30. In 1 degree there is 60 minutes. So the least count for this angle measurement is 2 minutes. Okay, so for magnification, we have two types of magnifier glass. One is 10x zoom and other one is 20x zoom. According to our requirement, we use this 10x and 20x zoom lenses. Stop the video. Okay, for observation table, for measurement, we have this type of observation table. So in we can see, this is a profile for our screw thread. So in we can see that this is minor diameter, then pitch circle diameter, and then major diameter, and it is a thread angle. To measure, when we magnify this on profile projector, so we have get two readings in profile projector. One is initial reading and other one is final reading. On one main scale reading and one vernier scale or circular scale reading, for if we are calculating the above 3 point, major diameter, minor diameter and pitch, then this we use circular scale reading, and if we are measuring the angle, then we use vernier scale reading. Then by calculating the difference of initial reading and final reading, we get our answer as major diameter, minor diameter, pitch and angle. So now we move on to the operating of our profile projector. Okay, so for our observation table, we have to give the power supply to our profile projector. Here is a lamp. On this lamp, the light comes, and we place our object on this surface. So now you can see, we can't see what is the profile of this screw thread. For to identify the profile or magnify the profile, we have to use these lenses. So right now I am taking 10x zoom lens. So we have to type this 10x zoom lens in profile projector here. Now if I place the same screw thread on this bed, then you can see.
Start.
Okay, so I have placed this bolt on this bed. Now you can see that our screw thread profile is magnified by 10 times. By 10 times here. So you can clearly see we get this profile. Now I have to measure the major diameter, minor diameter, pitch and angle. For major diameter, we know the outer part of both the screw thread, the distance between this both the outer part, that is the crust part or the toe value. If we calculate the distance between these two, then we can find out the major diameter. For minor diameter, we can calculate the difference between or distance between these two roots. Okay, so we can calculate the minor diameter. For angle of thread, I have to measure one angle for this and difference between this. So I can calculate the angle. For pitch measurement, we all know the pitch is the distance between the same two consecutive point on the same profile, like a distance between this point and this point. For measuring this, what we have to do, first of all, you can see on this screen, there is two wire crossing each other in X and Y direction. On there are two lines, one line is in this Y direction and one line is in this X direction, and here is a small intersection point. So first what we have to do, we with the help of these two micrometers, we have to adjust this intersection point at any tip of any of the this thread. So by moving so now you can see first I am going to calculate the major diameter. For major diameter, I have to measure the distance between these two top points or outer point. So first I manage this intersection point at the tip of one thread. So now in this, distance traveled by this will be measured on this y-axis micrometer. As I can move this in forward direction, then this image will be go upward, and then again I calculate the other intersection point position. So I have to calculate two point position. So this one is initial reading and other one is final reading. So let's see that how we can measure the initial reading. So as you can see on this circular scale, if I can see, so this reading is from 0, 1, 2, 5, 10 main scale, 11, 12, 13, so and 14 also. So main scale reading is 14. Okay, so circular scale reading, for circular scale reading I have to check the line which is matched with this particular line. So from 0 to this 100, so I can see from this side clockwise. So you can see that the line matching with this is a point which is on 35, 36 and 37. So circular scale reading is 37. And so least count for micrometer, I can calculate the minimum measurement divided by number of part on circular scale. So minimum measurement is 1 mm, number of part on circular scale is 100, so least count is 0.01 mm. Okay, so now I can multiply this with the help of 0.01, so the total reading is 14.37. now I so this is 14 main scale reading, this is circular scale reading 37, this is multiplied by least count, that is 01. So total reading, the actual reading for this position is 14.37. now I have to move this in this forward direction. So this intersection point should be on this point. Okay, okay, so now you can see that our intersection point is on crest of opposite side. Now again I can calculate the reading on this. So if you can see the mains for final reading, the main scale reading is from 0, 5, 10, 15, 20, 21, 22, 23. So main scale reading is 23. Okay, now I have to calculate circular scale reading. So circular scale reading is on, if we I check on this, so for use I will use this scale from 0 from downward. So here if we check the alignment with this line on circular, this is 55 56, and this is 57. So CSR reading or circular scale reading is 57 and least count is 0.01. So that is 23.57. Okay, so what is the answer? For answer, so if we can, for answer calculating, we have to calculate FR final reading minus IR initial reading. So in this, if we calculate 23.57 minus 14.37, it's come out to be 0.9.20 mm. Okay, so this is my major diameter. For the same thing I can check for like initial reading, or now what we I can see if I have to measure minor diameter. So I adjust this cross wire, on this root. So now I can again calculate the initial reading. So initial reading, it is shown on the main scale reading is 15, and circular scale reading is like 43. Okay, so least count is 0.01, so it's come out to be 15.43. okay, so for final reading I have to move okay, so now intersection point is the opposite side of root. If I can check this reading, so on main scale reading it is getting the point 20, 21 and 22. So main scale reading is 22 and circular scale reading is like this is 41. Okay, so main scale circular scale reading is 41 multiplied by 01, so this is 22.41. 4 1. Then again for answer FR minus IR, so this is FR and this is IR, so it's come out to be 6.98. Okay, so this is 6.98 mm. Now I have to calculate the pitch. These both are done with the help of y-axis micrometer. Now I have to check the pitch. For the purpose of checking the pitch, I use the x-axis micrometer. So first I have to adjust this intersection point on a point on crust. Okay, with the help of both x and y direction. Now the distance on this is initial reading. Again, I have to move this bed till this intersection point goes on the next point on this screw thread. So the distance difference between on this x-axis, we get the pitch. So for this, if I check the reading, the procedure is the same for this micrometer. So I am just taking the reading. So this is 15, main scale reading is 15, and the circular scale reading is near about 98. So 98. Multiplied by 0.1, so it is 15.98. okay, so this is initial reading. For final reading, now I will move this x direction. So my bed is moving in left direction. So now this is the intersection point on this next thread. So the final reading for this is, if I calculate, then the main scale reading is 16, and the circular scale reading is, if I will calculate, this is 61, the number of part which is matching with this main scale, that is 61 multiplied by 0.01. So this is 16.61. Again, the final answer will be calculated with the help of this formula, final reading minus initial reading. So if I will calculate, this come out to be 63.63 mm. Okay, so this is 0.63 mm.
Start.
Okay, so next we have to measure the angle of this thread. For angle of thread, we use this vernier scale on this screen. So first of all, what we do, we match one of the line with the inclined with this thread profile. So by rotating this, okay, so now you can see this line is matching with the profile of this thread line. So now I will make the reading of this scale. So here are two scales, one is main scale and other is vernier scale. Okay, so main scale reading is here 112. So main scale reading is 112 degree. Okay, so now for vernier scale reading, I match the line on vernier scale with one of the line on main scale. So if I go and check, so I will found that the line of 15th part is matching with the main scale reading. So vernier scale reading is my own 15th part. Okay, so list down for angle measurement is that minimum measurement on this main scale is equal to 1 degree and the part on this vernier scale are 30. So main scale reading is 1 degree upon 30 and I know in 1 degree there are 16 minutes. So divided by 30, so it's come out to be 2 minutes. Okay, so initial reading for 15 into 2 minutes, so it is 112 degree and 30 minutes. Okay, so I will get 112 degree and 30 minutes. So now for final reading, I have to rotate this in this clockwise anti-clockwise direction and again I have to adjust this in line with okay so now this line first this line in this angle now I have matched this line with this angle so it comes out to be this angle. So now this is final reading. If I calculate the final reading on main scale, I will get on the main scale that is 68. So main scale reading is 68 degree. And on vernier scale, if I check the part that on the vernier scale is matching is 20th part which is matching with the vernier scale. So vernier scale reading is 20 and multiply by with 2 minutes that is least count. So the final reading is 68 degree and 40 minutes. Okay. So I have to calculate final reading minus initial reading. So it's come out to be 50 minute and 53 degree and 50 minutes. Okay, so this is the measurement for this screw thread. The same procedure we can use for this spur gear. We can also calculate the width of the teeth, height of the teeth, and addendum, dedendum, each thing we can be calculated. And one more thing what we can do with the help of profile projector. If we want to trace any of the profile or we have to study about the profile of any gear, any screw thread or tool angle for single point cutting tool, then just we have to use one little thing, that is I have to place the profile which I have to study on this bed. Like this, and I have to set it on 0. Okay, so simply I have to use this trace paper and I will can clamp this trace paper on now you can see that I have placed trace paper on this. Then now what can I do? I can simply trace this profile on trace paper with the help of any marking. So like Now you can see that with the help of this now you can see I will get the profile on this trace paper of any gear. So we can study about the errors on this tooth profile with the help of this trace paper, or I can calculate theoretically the addendum, dedendum, the depth on this trace paper also. One thing but we can other part we can do, if we want to check the accuracy of this gear, then we can get the master printed on this paper, and just putting this trace paper on this gear profile, I can check whether it is coinciding with this profile or this is matching or not. Okay, thank you everyone. This is Shrikant Bansal, assistant professor in mechanical engineering in JCRC Jaipur campus. So this is our experiment of profile projector.